Blackstone presents The Gentle Art of Murder by Jeanne M. Dams. This book is read by Kate Redding. 1. Wednesday, July 16th.
Very well, gentlemen. Let's begin. I presume that our missing colleague will appear in due time, but I do not propose to wait for him. We have important matters to discuss, and I, for one, am eager to be off on my holiday to Greece.
And who's keeping us all here, I'd like to know, said Dennis under his breath.
With any luck, he'll get caught in a political riot, replied Matt, frowning and sinking lower into his chair.
John Chandler, the department head, was droning on, apparently oblivious to the murmurings of his subordinates.
Of course I've often visited Greece before, but what architect can resist the pull of the pure classical influence that pervades that country? Not only the Acropolis with its unparalleled structures, but the small lesser-known gems that await one around every corner.
Another survey of art history lecture, murmured Will. Somebody wake me when he's finished.
The door opened, interrupting Chandler.
Ah, Mr. Andrews, so good of you to find time to join us. I'm sure your latest opus needed a great deal of arduous planning and attention. Mind you don't slip on that dusty patch. Clay or something of the sort, I assume. We really must ask the students to keep the studio a bit tidier. Eh, Mr. Singleton?
He directed a humorless smile at Dennis, whose sculpture students worked tirelessly to keep the studio as clean as was consistent with their work.
We could do, said Dennis. If the cleaner would honour us with her presence a bit more often than once a term. Budget constraints, my dear man. Budget constraints. Which brings me to the principal reason for this meeting. I'll not keep you long, but I thought you'd want to know well in advance that we'll all have to tighten our belts next term. I want you to look at your materials requests and cut them at least in half.
There was an immediate uproar of anger and disbelief.
We've cut to the bone already,
roared Sam Andrews.
I spent the morning trying to work out how my students can learn without film, chemicals, paper, and proper darkroom equipment. Perhaps, said Chandler sweetly, you've heard of digital photography? The latest thing, or so I'm told. I believe it requires neither film, nor darkroom, nor chemicals, only a camera and a computer.
Before the infuriated photographer could reply, Chandler turned to Matt.
And the same applies to your students, Mr. Thomas. Prints have been made for thousands of years by the ancient techniques you so admirably try to teach your students. But we live in the 21st century. The giclée print can be beautiful if properly done. I recommend it to you.
Even for that, the students need a proper colour printer, said Matt.
I've asked every term I've been here, but we still have only a cheap office. I'm sure your innovative and devoted young students can solve the problem, Mr. Thomas.
A quick intake of breath, sounding like a hiss, came from nearly everyone in the room. Matt's sexual preferences were well known, but only the head ever made snide and untrue suggestions that he numbered his male students among his amours. Matt's dark eyes flashed, and his cheeks turned a mottled red, but he shut his mouth firmly.
I believe that leaves only sculpture to deal with. Your expenses, Mr. Singleton, have been extremely heavy for the past several terms. The increased need for copper in the developing countries has driven the cost of bronze through the roof, said Dennis.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.